In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we welcome you to Mass on the fourth Sunday of Easter, also known as Shepherd Sunday, and also known as Vocations Sunday. And we're offering our Mass today for all people of the parish. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And when you go to the rest of us, forgive us our sins, and bring us the everlasting life.
Amen.
You must repent, Peter asked, and every one of you must
He spoke to them from another tongue, using many languages. And he said, "Save yourself from this cursed generation." They were convinced by the Lord, and they accepted him for himself and were baptized. That very day, about 3,000 were added to their number. The word of the Lord.
waiting, O Lord.
Jesus said, I tell you most solemnly, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold through the gate, but gets in some other way, is a thief and a brute. The one who enters through the gate is the shepherd of the flock. The gatekeeper lets him in. The sheep hear his voice. One by one, he calls his own sheep and leads them out. When he has brought out his flock, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow, because they know his voice. They never follow a stranger, but run away from him. They do not recognize the voice of strangers. Jesus told them this parable, but they failed to understand what he meant by telling it to them. So Jesus spoke to them again. I tell you most solemnly, I am the gate of the sheepfold. All others who have come are thieves and ruins. But the sheep took no notice of them. I am the gate. Anyone who enters through me will be safe. He will go freely in and out, and be sure of finding pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come so that they may have life and have it to the full. The Gospel of the Lord.
This morning we have a pastoral letter from Bishop Richard. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on the Wednesday of Communion, at the Mass of Christmas, the priests of the diocese renewed their priestly promises, and those present in the cathedral, representing all the faithful of the diocese, confirmed the commitment to prayer for our priests, and to work with them in the mission the Lord has given to the Church. Today, Good Shepherd Sunday, the entire Church focuses once more on prayer and reflection for priests, and specifically for vocations to the priesthood. Every one of us has a vocation, a calling, given to us by God, so that we can take our rightful place in the life of the Church and the world, bringing the message of the Gospel to those around us in accordance with God's will for us as individuals and for his people. This is a consequence of our baptism, life lived in the love that exists in the Blessed Trinity. For those called to the ordained priesthood commit themselves to the service of Christ and his people. The priest celebrates the sacraments with and for the whole Church, specifically for those he is sent to serve. He preaches the word in accordance with the teachings of Christ and his Church. He is a leader in the community, a leader through service. The promises of the priesthood, prayer, obedience, celibacy, enable him to give his life in service and to be a sign of the kingdom of God for the world. To say that this is, for those called to it, the most wonderful vocation is an understatement. We become the people God calls us to be when we truly respond to his call. Every vocation brings challenges along the way, but also the greatest joy. For those called to priesthood, this response enables them to find the fulfillment that God himself desires for them. It is fulfillment found in the Eucharist, in prayer and in the service. I also have attended masses of induction for our parish priests. Will have heard me ask for prayer. I ask you today to pray for our priests every day, asking the Lord to strengthen and sustain them in service to all. I ask you also to pray for those in our diocese whom the Lord calls, who will be open to listen to his call and answer with complete generosity of heart. Pray for our five seminary students, for those in the earlier stages of discernment, and for those who have yet to experience the first stirrings of the call to priesthood. For some, like myself, such reflections can begin at an early age, as a grace flowing from the sacrament of confirmation. For others, the awareness of God's call comes a little later in life. The example of a priest living priesthood with joy and commitment is an almost universal element in the discernment of a priestly vocation. Like so many priests, I give thanks to God for the example of a priest deeply committed to the service of those in his pastoral care. When the fortune of priesthood is shared with others, it needs to be met with gentle encouragement and prayerful support, especially from parents. This Good Shepherd Sunday, I invite you to join me in a time of prayer for vocations to the priesthood in our diocese, leading up to Pentecost Day. To assist us in this time of prayer, a leaflet has been produced outlining an intention for each of the coming weeks and providing a prayer itinerary for this journey to Pentecost. There are some hard copies of this leaflet available in the porch, intended for those who do not have access to the internet, where you will also be able to find the prayer card. I am grateful to Father Tristan Cranfield, our Vocations Director, for putting this together, and I know that the prayers of all in the diocese will bear fruit. I also ask that in every parish, a mass for vocations for the priesthood is offered each week. This is already the practice in many places, as at times of Eucharistic adoration, especially for this important intention. The Good Shepherd calls us to himself and our priests through the proclamation of the word, through being the Lord's instrument in the celebration of the Eucharist and other sacraments, and through their leadership and guidance, hold a necessary place in the mission of the Church, that all may come to the sheepfold of Christ himself. May this Good Shepherd Sunday and the time that follows to our celebration of the coming of the Holy Spirit upon our Lady and the Apostles be a period of fervent and fruitful prayer for us all. With every blessing, Richard, your bishop. Continue to use the baptismal symbol of the Roman Church, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven. And is seated at the right hand of the God of God Almighty. From there, he comes to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body,
and the life everlasting. Amen. brothers and sisters, the Lord guides us along the right path. He is true to his name. And so we pray.
For the shepherds of our souls, especially our clergy, may they be ardent yet gentle servants of the gospel. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who were baptized, received, and confirmed. May they continue to follow God's call and find their fulfillment. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For those taking exams and all who are in love, may our learning and achievements be put to the service of the church. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For vocations to the priesthood, the diaconate, and the religious life, may those whom God chooses be open to this. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For those who are sick, housebound, lonely, or otherwise in need, may the Lord, present with his crook and his staff, give them comfort. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For those who have died, those with anniversaries of this time, may they now dwell in the Lord's house forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We ask Our Lady, Queen of the Clergy, to pray for us and with us as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
In a moment of silence, we pray for the spirit of discernment in our lives.
Almighty Father, we have come back to the shepherd and guardian of our souls, asking you to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thanks to your God.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father.
And the Lord has set the sacrifice of your hands, and the praise and the glory of his name, the power and the glory of his name.
Grant, we pray, Lord, that we may always find delight in these powerful mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thomas James, our
Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Lysis, Dallas, Sixers, Olivius, Cyprian, Loris, Rishonius, John and Paul, Cosmos and David, and all the saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protection. Therefore, Lord, we pray you graciously accept this donation of our service, grant to your whole family, order our days in the peace, and command that we be delivered to the end of that nation, and count among the flock of those you have chosen. We please, O God, we pray, to bless the knowledge and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, one of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for them, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Amen.
forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
By the help of your mercy, you may be always free from sin and saved from all distress. As we await the blessed hope from the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my next sacrifice. Look not on our sentences on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with
you. And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
So there's a limited number of printed newsletters. It's a double edition, and these are intended for those who don't access the internet. There are a few copies of the Bishop's Park for the letter, and I want to read again. They're really intended for those who don't access the internet, as I said in the Bishop's Park for there's the Vocations prayer card. There's a few copies of those, again, intended for those who don't access the internet. And the primary collection today is for the education of future priests in our diocese. So we have fully many information for the Diocese of Arundel and Brighton, and it costs about £150,000 to put a man through the seminary process. And I can see what you're thinking. I can see looking at me and going, what value for money that is. Cheap at half the price. Now I'm away on holiday. Wednesday of the 3rd of May, and returning to celebrate Vigil Mass of the 6th Sunday of Easter on the 13th of May. So there's no weekday Mass in the parish while I was away. Of course, St. Leonard's and Eastbourne are not far away. For the 5th Sunday of Easter, we go from Father Chris Fenden to celebrate the 3 Sunday Masses, so that's the Vigil, the 9th and the 11th. He wasn't really well a couple of weeks ago, but we have checked with him on Friday and said it's okay. So we are expecting him. Next Sunday, the 9th of Mass here at St. Martha's includes the May procession, and then after Mass, the CWL are holding their very popular sausage sizzle, and there is a highlight of the year. Just sits between Easter and Pentecost as the most important piece of the year. Yeah, it's very popular and I may well enjoy it. You always seem to put it on the weekend like a rain. So we have the final blessing and Regina Jenny and the final hits. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ and baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, and united with him in the holy land of heaven.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the God by your life.
Thanks be to God.
If you need the words of Eugene Chamber, it's 6:46. Lord, I
pray. No, there's no.